Hey you guys, welcome back to my Save the Cat series where I'm going over the 15 beats in Save the Cat Writes on Ravel during the month of November. I hope that it's helping you along so far. We've done Act 1 and last time we entered into Act 2 and now we're into Act 2 and today's topic is, well today's beat is B story character. Before I start, I just want to remind you that all those videos are in a playlist linked in the description box below for you guys to have easy access to it and you can watch it at any time. I do recommend that you go back and watch the beats thus far. We are on beat number 7, so let's jump right into what exactly it means to have a B story character. So what does it mean to have the B story character? This means that you are going to introduce the character that's ultimately going to teach your main character the theme of the novel. So this is what you need to know about the B story. Like I just said, they are there to teach your character the theme of the novel. So remember how we said that Act 2 was the upside down of Act 1? This includes people. So the people in Act 2 are going to be completely different than the people in Act 1. And this B story character is going to be unique. He or she is going to be special because they will ultimately be teaching your character the theme of the novel. What I want to mention also about the characters, you can introduce as many characters as you want in Act 2. However, this B story character, he's or she is unique. Remember, they are the special ones. They are the ones that are going to drive the message to the character to ultimately learn their lesson. Also, what you need to know about the characters in Act 2 is that they represent a different story than what the characters in Act 1 represented. The characters in Act 1 were all about the your main character's status quo, her life with those people as they are. And now everyone that you're introducing or that you're interacting with in Act 2 has to be related to her upside down world, to the way her world is now and how she's trying to navigate it going forward, trying to figure out how she's going to get through her new way of thinking, her debate, her catalyst, how she's solving this new problem that she has. Those characters that you're introducing in this B story, the second act, I should say, not the B story, but the second act, they are also the upside down of Act 1. So the B story character, you're going to introduce them in a single scene beat, and they're going to be introduced in the first half of the second act. They will appear throughout the entire second act and sometimes even in the third act, but not necessary. The whole point is that they guide your character to learning the theme. This new character can show up in a form of a new love interest, a new friend, an enemy, a mentor, whatever it is, they need to show up in the second act in a single scene beat during the first half of the second act. And finally, you can have a B story character be more than one person. However, make sure that both of them are equally showing and guiding your main character to learning the theme. And make sure that you have strict guidelines for each of them and what each of them represent in the story. All right, you guys, that is it for the B story character. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe before you leave because you don't want to miss the next videos that I have coming up. And again, if you have not watched the last 6 beats, make sure you go back and watch it so you can stay up to date with the videos that are coming up. I'll see you guys again in a brand new video in a couple days. Until then, stay safe.